Hello and welcome back. Here we have data with the employee name, first name, last name, date of joining, etc. Now, what many users actually want to do is copy this data repeatedly from different worksheets and paste it into another workbook. For example, in this workbook, let me open that. Here, they want to paste the data repeatedly into this workbook. So I'm going to just delete this first, save it, close this. So the first step the user would do is copy this, the headers, go to that worksheet. Here, this one, and go to home, paste, paste special, and in this window, he would just select transpose and OK. So he got the headers. The next thing, I'm just going to save this and close this. The next thing he wants to do is copy this data . Select this cell and paste it here. Again, paste special because he wants to transpose the data. He doesn't want to do any calculations, nothing. Okay, no operations. Just transpose, okay. Now, why did I do that in two steps? Now, for example, if he wants to paste more data from other workbooks, then he doesn't need this. So he will only paste the required data into the next columns. Alright, so I'm going to just delete this now. Keep this as it is because we don't need to do this one when we are doing the automation. Okay, so how can we now automate this complete process? So what we do is first we copy the headers and paste them in the other workbook. Now our job is to get this sort of data here, the real data, into that workbook automatically. Okay, so for that we go to the developer tab, insert, and we insert a command button, because most of us love to click on command buttons and do the automation. It's very intuitive. So we draw a command button. We can change its caption by going to the developer tab, control properties, and we could write an interesting caption like copy data, paste data in another workbook, and transpose. So we wrote this. Now, as you can see, this may be very long and it doesn't fit onto our button. So we can go below to the word wrap feature here, and instead of false, we can make that true. And then we close this here. And as you see, it fits perfectly. Even if you make this slightly smaller, it should fit. And there it is. Okay. Now we are going to code this command button. So we double click on it. Now between these two lines of code, we write our own code. Okay. So the first thing we did manually was to be in our active sheet and select the range. And after selecting the range, what we did was we copied the range. Okay. So we can straight away write ActiveSheet.Range.Copy. So we define the range that we wish to copy, and this time we will copy the data which has no headers because we have the headers already in our other workbook. Okay. The next thing we do is open the other workbook. So I'm going to write workbooks.open. Then the file name that we want. Now we need to define here the complete path to the workbook. So I'm going to copy and paste that. I have written it down in a notepad file. So there it is. I have written the complete path. The hard disk, users, the name of the user, desktop, and the file name. Okay. Once we have done this, we need to find out which is the next empty column where we can paste the data. Right. So we will say E column, just like for E rows, if you remember, E column will be assigned the value active sheet. Dot cells. I have done this in great detail for the rows, so it's a parallel one for the columns. You can read about that and even watch the video that I have created. I'll give a link to that also, to the E rows. So N, we are going to the left, Excel left, because that is where actually it's Excel 2 left, because we will then start counting from the extreme left to the right and find the blank or empty column. So dot column. Okay. We have found our blank column. Now we will always go to the column next to it in case there is some data. So we have some data there. We have our headers. So we will say if E column is greater than or equal to 1, then assign E column the value E column plus 1. So it goes to the next column when it finds some data on the left hand side. And this is exactly where we want to paste our data, but we first need to define the cell. That's exactly what I did even in the manual mode. I find the cell where I will start the pasting. So active sheet dot cells. And now since I have the row number, the row index number, and the column number, I can define the cell using the E column. Alright. And this is the cell I will select where I will start pasting. Okay. Now we write the paste special code. Selection dot paste special. That's what we did exactly in the manual mode also. And paste. What do we want to do? We want to paste all the data. So Excel paste all. Then the operation, do you remember? There were many operations, add, multiply, divide, and we want to do none of that. So Excel none. And in case we had blanks, we don't want to skip them. So skip blanks. That will be assigned the value false. And now do we want to transpose? Yes. So transpose true. So once we have pasted, we want to close the active workbook. First we save it and then we close it. So active workbook dot close. Why do we do all this? So that we don't keep on getting messages and then we would have to of course manually click. So to avoid that, we write this code. And finally we go back to our sheet where we have the command button, And there when you come back, you will see that the data that you selected, the range A2 to A4, F4 is highlighted. So to remove the highlight, we write this line of code, application, which is excel.cut, copy mode, and that we assign the value false. Alright, so our code is done. So, now we save this, close this, and get out of the design mode by clicking on the developer and clicking on the design mode. You will see these handles disappear as soon as I get out of the design mode, and there it is. So now if I click, I should get this data copied, pasted in the workbook that I will open, and the data should also be transposed as it is written on the command button. So I click on this. So there it is. Let's go to our file, open. This is the copied file, and there you see the data has been copied. I'll close this now and click again. Okay, and let's see what happens. Let's go back to our file, and there you see the data has been copied again. In this manner, you can copy data from different workbooks to this file and have a database. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.